Construction and material. Balance between attire and clothes, typological, constructive, and stylistic. Balance between of functions of attire, of presentation, of constructive, sacred, and aesthetic functions. Also, artistic design. But of course, chronological and essential boundaries are not sharp. The constant important function of all times is presentation, but in different times it requires different spheres. A natural talent originated during primitive era, its elements were resolved in ethnographic suit. Adornments mainly decorate the body. Their forms and general structure of the attire correspond to its parts. Head, wreath, head, ring, sockle, wide necklace, belt, bracelet, earrings. Adornments were made of available natural materials. Artificial materials were beginning to be used, of course. The joining between adornments, made by the way of wrapping, tying, stringing, piercing. Natural materials are not really solid to provide long and strong joining and dissolving of adornments. There is no essential balance between clothes and adornments. Natural attire may be put on without clothes. Constructive function of attire in a costume in the whole is almost absent. Presentational, sacred, and aesthetic functions born in unity as in primitive syncretic culture in the whole. They appoint the place of every man in the social structure. The crown of the ruler is an insignia of the status, sacred relic of a tribe, and beautiful theme simultaneously. In the costume of sacred leader, the sacred function of attire looks as the main, because the presentational and sacred ones can coincide. Aesthetic function is not very important. Details of the costume, in this case, details of the costume are full of sense. Definite artistic styles are absent. Different decoration and colors are used. The election is minimal. Decoration and artistic design are regulated with customs of people tribe, so it is display of presentation of function again. Heavy metal attire has existed since the era of metal and during the Middle Ages. Heavy and numeral adornments of not precious metal were produced by forging and casting. They fastened and kept draped clothes on the body, united with it into a single structure. The attire of Finno-Ugric peoples fully represents this stage. Metal details of the costume take the form of household items, tools, or armaments. Metal is able to provide solid connection. Some items of clothes cannot be put on without metal details and adornments. General structure of attire corresponds to a suit construction. Some things played the role of cut case, spiral, and holder, or of supporting framework, head, hoops. Others cover cloth with metal layer, sewn and hand in place, interwoven spirals. Some adornments lose their connection with the body because of their heaviness, temporal prints, are supposed to appear just on this stage. Special construction imitating fiat lace were found. The specific of a presentation of function is in the costume is defined with great role of war in the life of societies, with presentation of military men and leader. In the male attire, there are few adornments. The attire armaments is absorbed, or adornments to armaments. In this main question of time, simple adornments didn't play the main role in this question. Constructive function of adornments and safe protection were most important. Metal subjects realized protective noise with jingle in the best way, and so solid material as metal can express their idea of protection also in the best way. Arm and armor are adornments for a man, and the adornments are arm and armor of a woman. Attire stayed on the post-stylistic level. Adornments from different regions and in different techniques are similar. With the increasing of complexity of techniques, first style appeared, polychrome and carved of chambly, enamel, and rosaneric incrustation. Jewelry attire is typical for class society, especially for developed middle ages. Jewelry is made of precious materials in difficult jewelry techniques, with an enamel, yellow, filigree. Byzantine and Russian medieval attire are their best examples. The general structure of attire corresponds to the dress of a more complex cut, human construction. Jewelry attire defines the ornamental structure of the costume in the whole. Several attires can be defined: head, diadem, stem, pendants, earrings, and so on, wrist, bracelets, hemline. Main attires underline with area of sewn plates. Jewelry items are linked together structurally and stylistically. Their connection with clothing is typological and stylistic. A silver bell-shaped pendants and back head net complemented Russian compound headdress kichka in Russian. A gold diadem in cloisonné enamel complemented band and dress diadem. Constructive connection of jewelry and clothes became not very important, though sometimes was preserved. Sewn plates are included in the construction and ornament of clothes. Presentational function is connected with the cost of attire. The price depends on using of precious materials and complex and fine work. Art and richness make the prestige. Sacred and aesthetic functions are in unity because of the defining role of religion in the life of states and peoples. A specific forms of adornments were worked out in the frames of different jewelry techniques. Yellow and filigree quartz have wider diversity of types and variants in comparison with enamel ones, but analogical ones also performed. Jewelry attire goes through complex stylistic evolution. The stylistic analysis allowed to identify three main stages in the whole complex of jewelry from Russian quartz, corresponding to the stage of ornamental development and imaging of Christian subjects, from geometrized delineations to natural and to exaggerated and lush. You see the tables, the result of the previous report in previous meeting in Glasgow. Accessory attire is characteristic to the new time and modernity. Adornments are made from the variety of material and techniques, exist as other costume accessories. The attire hasn't defined structure. and construction. Items exist separately as a rule. In the 19th century, ensemble has formed named carrure from earrings and brooch, a decorative brooch. They are linked stylistically and with color harmony. The adornments complement the suit. They can be replaced and changed. They are rather independent from the structure, typology, and sign times in sometimes in style of the suit, but it is not the rule. Adornments don't lead, I suppose. Attire can be very modest, such examples. The costume can exist without attire. Also, the tendency of attire to go out from the suit is observed. Jewelry corresponds to artistic trends and fashion of the time in great deal, the tastes and preferences of the men. Stylistic unity of costume and attire adornments exists. In most cases, the adornments don't have any sense, except parting when they took part in science use related to specific events and subcultures. Specific adornments fulfill the presentation function, but in the whole, its sphere is limited. Costume of monarchs resolved elements of jewel presentation will tire in official sphere, but in other spheres, kings and queens use beautiful adornments. The main function of attire in a whole is aesthetic. The attire is becoming more individual and formed by a concrete person. We can say that a person is presented with beauty. Thank you.